पवन रेड्डी, पवन, अश्विनी,
हेलो सर, इस
बिंदुनी जूमिलో జాయిన్ అవ్వమని చెప్పండి అమ్మా.
ఓకే సార్, చెప్తాను సార్.
జాయిన్ అని చెప్పి స్క్రీన్ పైన ఫస్ట్ పేజ్ ఉంది కదా,
ఓకే సార్, చెప్తాను సార్.
ఓకే. सिंगर
Hello, good morning, Balkrishna sir.
Sir, good morning, Chandrasekhar sir. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good morning to everyone.
Good morning, sir. Rajendra sir.
Sir, chapter sir.
Can you put that opening slide?
I don't have open slide, na.
Tejaswaridhi.
Tejaswaridhi, inka raale sir. Tejaswar Reddy and Migitha vallu unnaru kada. తేజేశ్వర్ రెడ్డి ఫస్ట్ పిపిటి షేర్ చేయమ్మా ఫస్ట్ స్లైడ్ పెట్టు
సార్ కోహోస్ట్ చేయండి సార్
చేశానమ్మా
ఓకే సార్ థ్యాంక్స్ సార్
షేర్ ఆడియో పెట్టడం వచ్చి ఆడియో పెట్టడం వచ్చి తేజేశ్వర్ రెడ్డి షేర్ ఆడియో పెట్టడం మర్చిపోకు
ఒకసారి ఆడియో ప్లే చేయమ్మది ఒకసారి
సరే సరే చేస్తున్నాను సార్ సార్ ఓకే సార్
ఓకే ఓకే ఓకే
ఓకే ఓకే ఆపే
సార్ స్క్రీన్ ఓకేనా సార్
యా ఓకే
ఓకే సార్ థాంక్యూ సార్
ఇక్కడ రీచెస్ కింద ఇది రాలేదే
సార్ అది మళ్ళీ కొత్త చేంజ్ చేశాం సార్ నైట్ పైన ఆచార్య నాగార్జున యూనివర్సిటీ అని లేదు సార్
ఓకే 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 ఇట్స్ ఓకే सर चंद्रशेखर सर
यस सर
वी विल वेट फॉर अदर गेस्ट टू जॉइन सर एंड वी विल स्टार्ट वंस ऑल द अदर गेस्ट जॉइन सर
श्योर सर नो वरी आई विल बी ऑन म्यूट
ओके सर थैंक यू सर
హలో సార్, కెన్ యూ హియర్ మీ?
హలో
హలో సార్, ఎస్ సార్, యు ఆర్ ఆడిబుల్ సార్.
దిస్ ఇస్ ప్రొఫెసర్ బాలసుబ్రమణ్యం.
సార్ 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 బట్ యువర్ వీడియో నాట్ విజిబుల్ సార్. కెమెరా మేబీ సమ్ వాట్ అప్ సైడ్. That means camera is not in correct position.
No, I am using only laptop.
I am laptop. Yes. Now it's correct.
It's coming?
Somewhat. Please down something, sir. Okay. Now it's okay, sir. Fine, sir. Fine, sir.
I am not able to see anyway my own image.
Yes.
Balu sir, good morning. Hello.
Good morning, Sagar garu.
వెల్కమ్ సార్. హలో హలో సార్, వెల్కమ్ సార్.
యా
సార్, sir, we will wait other guests to join, sir. We will start once all the guests join, sir.
Good morning, Dr. KMM Rao. Are you?
Balakrishnan sir, can you hear me?
Hello
sir, I can hear you, sir. Sir Vijayasagar sir, welcome sir.
Good morning, professor.
Good morning.
How are you?
I am fine. How are you?
I am fine too.
Okay. But we are not able to see the faces in this. Are you able to see? Oh. Okay, now I am able to see your face, but my face is not visible.
సాగర్ గారు, గుడ్ మార్నింగ్.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ సార్.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ విత్ మిస్టర్ విద్యాసాగర్ బాలసుబ్రమణ్యం గారు.
Good morning, sir.
Lalita madam, good morning, madam.
Good morning, madam.
Hi.
Lalita gar, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Dr. Lalita Balaswamy here.
Good morning, sir.
I used to have one close friend at IIT Kanpur when we were doing PhD together. One Dr. P. G. Murthy. I think he was associated with this college. Am I right?
P. G. Murthy was with KLU also, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Was he there also?
Now he is not there.
Yeah.
Sir, he is associated with Bapatla Engineering College, sir. He worked here for a couple of years.
Right, I know. Actually, we were together in IIT Kanpur for our PhD.
Okay.
Later on in BHEL also in Delhi, we were together. How is he? Any idea about him?
I am fresher here, sir. Might be some old faculty, they might know, sir.
Okay.
Sir, good morning to one and all, sir.
Good morning.
Mr. Balakrishna, are you able to hear?
Good morning, sir.
Yes, madam. I think our videos are not coming up. I'm not sure where they're blocking or otherwise it is okay. Okay, without the video also. Mr. Balakrishna. Madam Rama, madam.
Yes, sir.
Madam, me video got louder, Ledandi. I'm not able to see a video.
Yeah, I think without the video, the bandwidth will be good for audio.
Okay, it is only audio allowed. Okay.
Sir, I think video option is there for everyone, but
no, madam, we are not able to see even though we activated the video, but I don't think so. Maybe some administrator, I think they may
sir,
be blocked.
Yes. Sir, this is Balakrishna, sir.
May
I know the problem, sir?
No, I am not able to see the video. Are you able to see your photo at least? Yourself, Mr. Balakrishna?
Yes, sir. I can see my
Now I am able to see yours.
But I switched it off.
But I am not able to see my photo. Are you able to see me? No.
No, sir. We are not able to see. Maybe related to webcam.
No, sir. We are not blocking anything.
We are not blocking
anything. Maybe once log out and log in, sir. Sometimes it will fix.
Sir, madam.
Sir.
Rama madam also is having sir, same problem.
Sir, our chief guest Sri Srinivas Jasigar joined, sir. Welcome, sir.
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead.
I triply
sir, I suggest you once log out and log in, sir. For us also, sometimes it fixes the problem.
If I log out, all of you guys will log out, ma'am. No problem. Can I log out once?
No, you can give the host to somebody, right?
Yeah. Co-host already there.
Sir, Srinivas Jasti, sir. Welcome, sir.
Good morning, Jasti, sir.
Yeah, good morning, ma'am. Good morning to one and all.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning.
Hello,
sir.
Yeah, Mr. Balakrishna, I think my audio is audible. Yeah, no?
Sir, your audio is clarity, sir, in clarity. Sir.
But the video is not coming. I'm not sure what is the problem. Yeah, you know, let us go ahead with this.
Okay, sir. Sir, shall we start, sir? Priyanka, are you ready? Hello. Bindu Tejas Reddy, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Priyanka, is my voice audible?
Yes, sir, it is audible.
Okay, can you start the program?
Yeah, sure, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Respected chief dignitaries, eminent speakers, esteemed guests, and all volunteers and all my dear friends, a very pleasant morning to one and all. I am Priyanka Valli Dasi, Vice Chair of IEEE Student Branch of Bapatla Engineering College. I would like to present a gracious welcome to you all to the inauguration of IEEE Student Branch at Bapatla Engineering College. This event is the glory of teamwork and wants to be a tillage of enormous to achieve the auspicious remark. On behalf of IEEE Student Branch, I'm the host of this morning. Let's gonna start our event. Now, I appeal to Mr. Surya Nirmal Verma, Chair of IEEE Student Branch, to deliver the event introduction and welcome note.
Thank you, Priyanka. Very pleasant morning to everyone who present here. I am Surya. For today gathering, all to these are tough times with COVID cases increase. We hope that all are you are safe. We know that the importance of vaccination, so I request everyone to go through it. We are here for the inauguration of IEEE Student Branch for IEEE Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers. IEEE, the world's largest technical professional organization dedicated to advanced technologies for the benefit of humanity. And we are happy to say that once again, we are starting our IEEE Student Branch in BEC. Bapatla Engineering College has been established in 1981 with a vision to impart quality education, and also it is the one of the foremost private engineering college in southeast coast of India. We have a golden opportunity by getting placed in this college. We are feeling very lucky to be a part of this college, and for giving these opportunities, Now we have our student branch mentor, Dr. N. Ramadevi ma'am, and student branch counselor, Mr. N. Balakrishna sir, with respected dignitaries. Thank you for the petition team for accepting our petition. And thank you, principal sir, HOD ma'am, and Balakrishna sir, for giving us these opportunities. Thank you all for accepting our invitation and attending today's inaugural function. Now, let's have a glance of BEC.
Creating a platform for the students. First half day only syllabus, second half day we are giving them a lot of opportunity to concentrate on ideas, and also we are nurturing them to start an industry. We are also bringing investors, and also we are bringing the students.
Thank you, Mr. Surya, for sharing the event intro, and thank you for Tejeshwar Reddy for playing the glance video in the background. Now we shall have a prayer song. I request Mr. Tejeshwar Reddy to play an AV.
Yeah. ಸ್ವಾಮಿಯಾಯ ಗಣದೈವತಾಯ ಗಣಾಧ್ಯಕ್ಷಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ಗುಣಶರೀರಾಯ ಗುಣಮಂಡಿತಾಯ ಗುಣೇಶಾನಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ಗುಣಾತೀತಾಯ ಗುಣಾಧೀಶಾಯ ಗುಣಪ್ರವಿಷ್ಟಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ಏಕದಂತಾಯ ವಕ್ರತುಂಡಾಯ ಗೌರೀತನಯಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ಗಜೇಶಾನಾಯ ಬಾಲಚಂದ್ರಾಯ ಶ್ರೀ ಗಣೇಶಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ
Thank you for everyone for your possessive disciplinary towards the prayer. Intimacy with God renews the spirit, gladdens the heart, and helps to lead a happy life. Light is a pretty universe of symbolizing prosperity of truth and the knowledge. Now we will have a traditional lamp lightning by our esteemed guest. I welcome all the guests of this event. Dr. B. Chandrasekhar sir was a technical leader in our automotive division and TCS. And Dr. Jasti Srinivas Rao sir was a chair of IEEE Hyderabad session. And Dr. T. Vidyasagar sir was a chair of IEEE Hyderabad section. And Dr. SVNL Lalitha ma'am, chair of IEEE Guntur subsection. And Dr. V. Damodras Naidu sir, principal of Bapatla Engineering College. And Dr. N. Ramadevi ma'am, HOD of IEEE department and IEEE mentor of student branch of Bapatla Engineering College, to click on the lamp. And I heartily welcome others to join in a celebration as it's a part of our culture. Thank you to all dignitaries for your presence of this devotional culture. Now, I consider it's a great honor to invite Dr. V. Damodara Naidu sir, principal of Bapatla Engineering College, to address the gathering.
Yeah, thank you very much. Distinguished professors, distinguished delegates, and my dear esteemed colleagues, dear students, good morning and welcome to this inaugural inauguration of the IEEE student branch at Bapatla Engineering College. IEEE is the world renowned institution Yes. Good morning and welcome to this IEEE. IEEE, one of the world's largest technical organization, bringing together students and researchers in this common platform to share their ideas and bringing together the research findings for the benefit of the entire world. I think this is a great opportunity for the students of Bapatla Engineering College to use this opportunity and facility to bring in their ideas and also and their research findings to share with the world researchers for the benefit of their progress and also for the benefit of the community. In Bapatla Engineering College, we have 4 decades of journey in providing quality education to the students in the rural area of Andhra Pradesh. Our college is one of the renowned college in South India. We have about 5,000 students with 9 UG programs and 11 PG programs. And we are also placing the students in advanced placement of 6 months in advance. That means after completion of seventh semester, they have given opportunity to go to industry and work and complete the remaining course. That means last semester they can complete while working. This opportunity we have been giving for last 2 years, and about almost 100 students have been utilizing this facility. This is a great facility for the students who are getting their on-campus placement. I thank the chair of IEEE Hyderabad, Dr. Srinivas Jasti, and also Dr. Srinivas Jasti and Dr. T. Vidyasagar, chair of IEEE Hyderabad section, SAC, and also Dr. Lalita SVNL, chair of IEEE Guntur section, for accepting the request of our student to start the student branch at Bapatla Engineering College. Thank you. Wish you all the best. Thank you once again. Thank you. Yeah, please go ahead.
Thank you, sir, for your gracious presence and sharing your views. And now it's a great privilege of inviting Mr. Jasti Srinivas Rao, sir. Glad to open the inauguration clip of the event.
Jasti, sir, shall we start, sir? Inauguration.
Yeah, please, go okay. ahead.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. And now it's a time to listen to the words of the guest, Mr. Jasti Srinivas Rao, sir. And it's a great honor to me to introduce Mr. Jasti Srinivas Rao, sir. He received his bachelor degree in mechanical engineering from Usmania University. And he certified a quality analyst with ME in mechanical engineering from Birla Institute of Technology and Science. He grown like a role model for us with his effort and persistence. And he role as he served in his span, Secretary of IEEE at 2010 and Vice Chair of IEEE in 2011 and Secretary cum Treasurer from 2011 to 2013 and Vice Chair in 2014 and Chairman in 2015 and Treasurer of IEEE from 2016 to 18 and served as a member of IEEE from 2019 to 2020 and now he's a Chairperson of IEEE. And he has around 22 plus years of overall experience in IT industry, spanning across the industry verticals of banking, financials, retail, and communication media and information services. And he has been a TCS in all his years handling various roles across the development, quality, product, and the support, etc. Now, I take the privilege of inviting Mr. Jasti Srinivas Rao, sir, to speak few words on this auspicious occasion.
Yeah. I'm audible, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you. Loud and clear.
Yeah. Thank you, Priyanka. It was a big introduction, but I have been associated with IEEE for all my years when I joined TCS after my post-graduation. So the way I leveraged IEEE was to get insights of the current happenings And it was a real good source or authentic source. I need not worry if something is coming from IEEE organization, then it is like an authority, or it is like, so that's how it was useful for me all my career. Yeah, so it was really helpful in trying to come up with some solutions or thought process and all of that. So my association goes long back with IEEE as well, as equal to the span of my association with TCS. Okay, coming to the inauguration, I congratulate the student branch for initiating or taking steps to the student branch. Though it was there in the past, it was not active, and it's a good thought that you guys have really come forward to take it forward. And congratulations on getting the student branch accepted by IEEE as well. And I would also congratulate the principal sir, then the management committee, which has really authorized and been supportive to the student branch counselors as well as the students to come up with this student branch and then raise the benefits which IEEE can actually enable them. It's a golden source of information. Now it's the sky is the limit for all of you students to understand which area you want to get yourself introduced to, and then also understand what is very current in that area in terms of research, especially the postgraduate students who are at a stage where they want to take their career step, whether they want to move on into research or whether they want to move on into any of the industry forums. For both the categories, IEEE has different levers which they need to pick up as to which direction they want to travel. So this enabler from the college is a very good boon for all the students of Bapatla Engineering College. Now it is up to them to leverage and continue this association with IEEE. Apart from, this is on the larger scale of IEEE. I'm not going to, tell what exactly the benefits of IEEE and all, which will anyway be conveyed through Vidyasagar Garu and his team or the membership development chair, Saurabh, in the subsequent weeks, probably to get a better insights as to what IEEE is all about and how one can benefit from leveraging the resources that IEEE provides. Yeah, and second, coming to this student branch itself, the way you need to pursue this opportunity as get the insights of the current happenings in the industry or what IEEE is doing in the research areas. The way it blossoms is research is the beginning of any new solution or new area of evolution. And once research takes a logical step, that gets handed over to the industry for possible solutions which can be leveraged by the community at large. So that is the life cycle. So you will get very good insights as to life cycle of a particular area you pick up. The industry 4.0 is a real on the peak right now. So there are different areas which are available with that. And all those areas, you can get very good insights as well as leverage the current contextual information and see if you can come up with solution for community around you. Your principal sir was saying it's like a college in a rural area, and so we are serving the community in the rural area. That's a great noble cause or a thought which is being done to the committee and community. At the same time, you guys are well placed. All the students who are there, who are going through this engineering courses, engineering should be treated as a thought process to come up with solution, not just only of academic interest. You have to blossom your thought. Okay, it is no longer I'm coming to a college just to learn something and go out and do something. No, you are being given some insights on a particular course, be it civil engineering, mechanical engineering, electronics, or computers. So your thought process should change that you are an independent identity in that field. So how do I stand myself in that? If you want to stand yourself, then you have to, have your concepts very strong. And then your mindset has to get into a direction where you will try to find solutions to the problems around you. You have to start something which in your neighboring areas, then you can, the scale can automatically come to the solution which you are going to give. So I would recommend you reach out to all the, villages around, and probably try to draw some inspiration as to what are the kind of problems they are facing, be it in the agriculture stream, be it in the regular, whatever your carry forward of the family, for example, groceries, how things are being procured, how those systems are getting put in place. So there are a lot of things which you can enhance. Yes, things are running. You don't have to start something new. Things are running, but you can bring efficiency, you can bring enhancement, you can bring comfort on what is being done in a better way with lesser cost. So these are some of the benchmarks which you need to keep for yourself. How can I do things better? How can I do things at a lesser cost? How can I do things at a better efficiency? I think with these thoughts, you need to again pick which area of industry, be it mechanical, be it artificial intelligence, be it in any of the area, how that solution can be arrived at. It can be a collaboration effort. Now it is no longer in the industry, a civil engineer can do only civil works. The smart cities as a whole about, the civil engineer should be knowing what kind of devices should be brought into place and what kind of interactions happen, what kind of control system to be put in place. It is a multi-dimension. So each of you who are currently in each of the branches should not restrict your understanding of the engineering to only that discipline. You need to broaden your scope and understand how the interactions will happen. And come to the mechanical stream, robotics, control systems. It is a multidisciplinary, computer science. So all three, knowledge of all three is required for the mechanical engineer to come up with solutions these days. Be it in healthcare or any of the other industries, like healthcare is currently prominent because of the pandemic situation where the solutions are being found. And again, IoT. IoT is one area where the interactions, cuts across all the disciplines to come up with solutions. So on that note, I would again reiterate the fact that your ideas or your thoughts should not restrict to discipline and should be with a mindset that you find solutions to the problem around. Wherever you are coming to college today, from your home, you observe things that are happening around and then ignite your thoughts as to what I can come up with solutions for some of the problems which are appearing day to day. I can't be naming them because you need to feel the pain of the problem. Then only you'll be able to find the solution and you will have that driver to come up with a solution. So put your thoughts around that. Okay, coming to Hyderabad section by itself, it has created a lot of mechanisms which can benefit the students. One is the mentorship program, the Skill Connect program, and a lot of other, the access to experts in the field of interest. That is a golden opportunity for each of you to hear from people in the industry, people from the research who will come directly and connect with you and deliver some thoughts on an area of interest, maybe the advanced. If a researcher is coming on board, a professor who is delivering a DL, so he will be an authority in that subject. He is coming directly and interacting and giving some thoughts to you. So that opportunity is another thing which each of you should be leveraging. Okay, access to Hyderabad resources, that is very much available. Senior professors are there. As well as people from industry are available as part of the Hyderabad section Exicom, as well as a volunteer base which we have. So you also should feel the necessity within yourself to reach out, and that hunger, you need to display that hunger that I want to grow, I want to reach out to people, I want to find answers for my own solution. Don't wait for somebody to come and solve your problem or tell you that you do this, you do that. All you need to know is where are the resources available, and it is up to you how you figure out how to get access to the resources and how you will leverage the services from that resources. Like say, for instance, I will tell you, today we have people from industry. You may want to connect with somebody. They are not available for you, maybe 1 week, 2 weeks, whatever you are trying, but you should be persistent. If you display that hunger, they will also come forward. they may be occupied. It is not that they don't want to help you or anything. They may be occupied with other priorities which are there for you. You have to display your hunger. As the saying goes, attention will be paid only to a crying baby. So on that note, I would like to conclude and wish you all the best to continue this journey for the long years to come forward, like how we have 4 decades of journey of BEC. I would suggest our association with IEEE also continues with such long journey, so that the benefits which are available, the access to resources, the access to knowledge will all be a privilege of these students of BEC. Again, once again, thank all the stakeholders for having this organized, and again, Principal Sir and Management Committee for enabling this, and the professors who have come forward to be part of student branch counselors and mentors to enable this whole activity. Wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for devoting your precious time and endowing us with your words of wisdom and experience. It's really indeed of our great pleasure to have you with us on today. Once again, thank you, sir. And now, I request Mr. Sheikh Hassan, student branch member of IEEE, to introduce today's guest, Mr. T. Vijay Sagar, sir.
Good morning, all. I'm Sheikh Hassan, IEEE BEC student branch member, Third Year Electrical. It's my honor and privilege to introduce Dr. T. Vidyasagar sir, chair of IEEE Student Activity Committee, Hyderabad, and also past chair IEEE CS chapter, Hyderabad. He is holding 17 years of experience as cloud and data security architect in Tata Consultancy Services Limited. He is also one of the member of ICDT committee, one of the member of TFTCCI, and also one of the member of Internet Society as well as Hyderabad chapter. He is certified by Microsoft as a solution architect. He is also certified as an enterprise architect by TOGAF. And he is also a well-known speaker, mentor, blogger. Coming to his education, he completed his graduation in computer sciences and engineering, AI and ML of Vardhaman College of Engineering, Autonomous. He is certified as a professional in Microsoft SharePoint, and he is also certified as a in 347 Enable Office 365 services. He is certified in 70347 Managing Office 365 Identities and Requirements. One of his hobby is to travel to interior places of India. He is also a pet lover, common natural lover. This information would be a very very few words from his experience like ocean. We are happy for your presence in this occasion, sir. Thank you for giving this information. Thank you for giving this opportunity.
Thank you, Mr. Hassan. And moving on, now we invite Mr. T. Vijay Sagar, sir, to express his graceful words.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. Very good morning, Principal Garu of Bapatla Engineering College, and Jasti Garu, Chair of Hyderabad Section, Lalita Madam, and Chair of Guntur Subsection, and Balakrishnan Garu. Very great moment to start another student branch, and especially in the Guntur Subsection region, because in the last 3 months, there were many colleges have started their student branches in Narsarawapet, Vijayawada, and other places also. Student activity is most one of the main backbone of IEEE because of the large population and a place where we are conducting most of our events. And we are very happy that usually we see the computer society chapters, they start the student branch, and then the other chapters do come. But here it's triply started student branch. Which... Hello. Can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah, sir.
Okay,
sir.
Sorry, there is some disturbance. Yeah, coming to IEEE Hyderabad section, we are about 104 colleges, including your college too, as on today. And we span about 2,200 students from Hyderabad, Guntur, and Anantapur regions, especially. And we focus mainly on student enablement programs. One is the Skill Connect, which we are going to launch very soon, three-month course, online course on Java. Also, we are going to launch programs for faculty. We will launch another hackathon event. And most important thing is we are going to launch EvolveX on Teachers Day, on the eve of Teachers Day. I'm just giving an advance notice, which is basically creation of a live project and demonstration. So this requires not only just one stream, as Jasti sir mentioned. We want departments in your college to come together, like mechanical, CS, EEE is a combination. Think, innovate, and ideate, and come with new concepts and ideas. You will have all the certifications and rewards from section. And on October 23rd, IEEE Extreme, which is a global coding hackathon. The winners will get $10,000 USD, and the second is $7,000 USD. It's a global wide thing. So starting from today, we have around 15 faculty from various colleges came forward to train our students. So we are starting our first training today evening at 5 o'clock by one of the student, Sai Charan, who stood last year at 167 rank. So this year we hope to get a rank less than 100. So whatever I'm quoting, all these are various programs. By this time, you might have understood that the way we announced. And this year, we bagged, last month, we bagged 4 awards, which is our REM awards from IEEE. And these awards are 1,000 USD, a direct a cash prize to the student. So that is what Richard E. Mervin Award, when I say REM. So 4 of our students and one lady Divya from Anantapur also, she got this from Karnur. So as a student, you will connect to the external world. You won't be just sitting on the boundaries of Papatla. It is important for you. You have IEEE membership. So I urge every student, go and open IEEE.org and understand what exactly it is. You take some time, read it. You have IEEE TV, you will find all technical related videos there. And you have IEEE News Magazine, you will get a periodic updates on what technical things are happening. And you have IEEE Collaborative. Collaborative is a platform where throughout the world, live projects are happening. So it is a platform where suppose if you apply and you have been selected to that, your coach might be in Australia, your colleague team members might be in US or UK, and you will be sitting from India. You all will together will do that project. So this is where you will be exposed to the global world, and you will get an opportunity to speak and listen. The most important thing, you will get an opportunity to improve your technical skills and connect various people across the globe who are expertise in their own area. So you can't read all the technologies, right? It is very hard. You can't digest all. Sometimes we need to quickly listen. So as per statistics, if you read, you will get 30% knowledge. If you listen, you will get 30%. If you read, you will get 50%. But if you teach, you will get 100% knowledge. So we have so many students who are conducting a lot of programs. And that's how you need to plan. It's not just one student chapter opening. Balakrishnan Garu, you have to, with the support of Principal Garu, you have to open student chapters in every branch in BEC.
Yes, sir.
And we will have a separate session to give you a complete awareness on IEEE. Maybe next week or so we will give.
Sure, there are a few
student section representatives will give, so that you will get a better insights. And also, you should know every benefit of IEEE. For example, in this year only, we have 4 or 5 colleges who have already got 2,000 USD from IEEE for various programs. So if you know the policies, if you know how to apply for funds and all, you will get a lot of funds from IEEE. That is the first point. Second point, students who get recognition in IEEE, if they get any awards from IEEE, it will be very beneficial to them when they go for higher education in US or Australia or Europe. Because the first priority will be given to IEEE. They may get scholarships because they are members of IEEE. They have this good certification and all. So not only one area, IEEE will help you in many areas. And you should know how to do L31 reporting and all, the rules, the guidelines of IEEE, which we will educate you down the line within a week or 10 days time. But have more participation. This is the world's, not only a technical forum, the world's best professional network is IEEE. And go by cross-learning, which will help you a lot. We want both mechanical, IEEE, CS, all the students sit together, all the IEEE students, and have some weekly sessions, have some Friday coffee sessions, and just share your thoughts with others, what you read in IEEE in that week. That will help you. You should create some town hall concepts. Normally we have in TCS. So every Friday we used to have some sessions. Similar things you need to inculcate and educate. So once again, congratulations to all. Hope we'll have more vibrant and more participation from Bapatla Engineering College. And I wish this college to be one of the vibrant IEEE chapters down the line. And thank you for inviting us and for being with us. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir, for your philanthropic words. And we are the volunteers. Always remember your motivation and take you as an inspiration to success every task we take up. Once again, thank you, sir. And now I request Ms. Harshita, student branch member of IEEE and webmaster as well, to introduce today's guest, Dr. SVNL Lalita ma'am.
Thank you, Priyanka. A very pleasant morning to one and all. I am Harshita, webmaster of IEEE BEC student branch, currently pursuing third year electrical in Bapatla Engineering College. It's my honor to introduce Dr. SVNL Lalita Garu. She is the faculty chair of IEEE Women in Engineering student branch. Dr. Lalita ma'am obtained her BTech from SV University College of Engineering, Tirupati. Obtained her MTech in power system with a CGPA of 9.7. Dr. Lalita ma'am started her professional career as a junior engineer in Balaji Steels, Nellore. With a passion on teaching, she declined post and joined as a lecturer in KSRM College of Engineering, Kadapa in 1997. She played a key role in organizing a pink ribbon walk in Guntur city. Dr. Lalita ma'am is a life member of ISTE and a senior mentor of IEEE. She is working as a branch counselor for IEEE student branch and a chairperson of executive council of IEEE Guntur subsection. She is acting as Reaching Locals Ambassador of IEEE Art and Educational Activities Board. She organized several workshops in different areas. She conducted a many national level courses. She has more than 60 research publications to her credit and has presented papers at IEEE international conferences. She has filed a patent on assessment of voltage stability index for online voltage stability monitoring. She has co-authored a book chapter on microgrid protection. Dr. Lalita Ma'am acted as the Energy System Research Group Head, Power System Group Head, and Head of Stability Department. Her philosophy is education is a continuous process. The more you share, the more you accomplish. Thank you for giving me this wonderful opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Harshita. And now I invite Dr. SVN Lalita Ma'am to share her words with us on today's gathering.
Thank you, Harshita, for introducing me. I'm here as an IEEE volunteer. I would like to, am I audible?
Yes, madam.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am. Let me congratulate everyone of the Bapatla Engineering College family, the principal, Damodar Naidu Garu, and my friend, Dr. N. Ramadevi, and the branch counselor, Mr. Balakrishna, and the student branch chair, Surya Nirmal Verma, and our IEEE Hyderabad section Execom members, Srinivas Jasti sir, Balasubramanian sir, and Vidyasagar sir. Thank you very much, and the chief guest of today's function, Dr. B. Chandrasekhar from TCS. A very good event to be a part of Bapatla Engineering College. As I know from long, we used to come to Bapatla Engineering College for spot valuation when KL University was under the Nagarjuna University. And it's a very good college. And we have been having Dr. N. Ramadevi as the executive committee member of Guntur subsection earlier. Madam, because of her other commitments, this year she could not give her services as the Execom member. Thank you, madam, for once again revamping the entire IEEE activities in your student branch. And I should congratulate the branch counselor for taking the lead, and also the effort of our Guntur subsection student activities chair, Dr. Kishore Babu, in giving the inputs to the Bapatla Engineering College people. And we earlier had a event in BEC last year, I think, on virtual labs. We have conducted from Guntur subsection end a virtual labs training session in Bapatla Engineering College. And now the Guntur sub, I would like to share with all of you. Now the Guntur subsection is become very strong and very active. And now we have in our subsection, Krishna, Guntur, and Prakasam districts. So we have more opportunities of networking here. And we have been very active. And Vidyasagar sir also taking a lot of lead in mobilizing the students. And we are also trying to reach many of the colleges. Many number of colleges have started the IEEE activities in full swing. And from the subsection, we are giving all the help what is required. From the subsection, our earlier past chair is Eftronics Ramakrishna Garu. I think most of you will be knowing him. And at present, I am chairing the subsection. And Srinivas Reddy Garu from Acharya Nagarjuna University is the vice chair. And we have the entire team spread across all the universities and colleges in Guntur subsection region. So it's a it's very good that we are able to meet today. And I'm really eager to listen to the lecture, what is what has been planned on the power electronics side, which is of interest for me also. I thank all the organizers for giving me this opportunity, wonderful opportunity of meeting you all guys. all my members of the IEEE, they have already told you what are all the benefits of IEEE. And we are always with you from Guntur subsection. And I extend our wholehearted support for the functioning of your student branch. And as Vidyasagar sir has told, you can start the societies also. And I think it is the right time for you to mobilize the students with 50% of the discount in the student branch membership and Power and Energy Society for student members free of cost, and Computer Society free of cost for the students, Women in Engineering Affinity Group also giving free of cost membership for the students. So you try to explore reaching out to the more number of people. I have personally benefited a lot with the IEEE membership. You get to know about how different people from various organizations, they get together and do a thing as a teamwork. This is what you can learn from IEEE, the discipline and how to conduct the events. And as our chair keeps saying that starting is only a beginning and maintaining the activities is what we expect. So we would look forward for a great number of activities from your student branch, and do not neglect filing the L31s. Anyway, you will be receiving the total training related to the IEEE student activities. So already I think my time, we are running past the time. So once again, I congratulate everyone and thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you, ma'am. As your words are really great inspiration and remarkable, thank you for making our day, ma'am. And now it's a great honor of IEEE student branch of Bapatla Engineering College to present the virtual mementos for the guest, Mr. Jasti Srinivas Rao, sir. And Mr. T. Vidyasagar, sir. And Dr. SVNL Lalita, ma'am, of this occasion. Congratulations to all the guests. And once again, thank you to all for being a part of our occasion. And now I humbly request today's guest of honor, Dr. B. Chandrasekhar, sir, to unveil our IEEE Bapatla Engineering College logo. Thank you, sir, for unveiling the wonderful logo. And now I request Ms. Katyani, student branch member of IEEE from IEEE department, to deliver the description of logo.
Thank you, Priyanka. A very good morning to you all. I am going to explain the description of logo design for IEEE Bapatla Engineering College student branch. It's pleasure for all of us being a part in IEEE. IEEE is a collection of different streams and technologies. Based on the evolution of new ideas and technologies, IEEE making itself new day by day. In IEEE, everyone has an equal opportunity to explore their ideas. We use it to represent all the various technologies of Industry 4.0 in our logo. IEEE is a professional body which has grown by leaps and bounds with a collective teamwork. Where there is a teamwork and togetherness, wonderful things can be achieved. That's why we have inculcated togetherness and teamwork in our logo. Bapatla Engineering College was established in 1981, is one of the first and foremost private engineering college in the southeast coast of India, located near to famous beach called Suryalanka Beach. So we want to show the geographical location of our college in the logo. The Bapatla Engineering College was established in 1981 with a vision to impart quality education and is affiliated to Acharya Nagarjuna University. The college is a little away from the din and bustle of Bapatla, a town with historic and hoary past. In these 40 glorious years, our college main building stands tall in front of us, and we consider that as a monument pride. It's very glad to see our college main building in the IEEE Bapatla Engineering College student logo. Finally, this is the complete logo of IEEE Bapatla Engineering College student branch. Thank you for giving this opportunity.
Thank you, Ms. Kathyayani, for giving such a brief description of logo. Now I request Ms. Alekya, student branch member of IEEE and treasurer as well, to introduce today's guest of honor, Dr. B. Chandrasekhar, sir.
Thank you, Priyanka. A very pleasant morning to one and all. It's a great pleasure to me to introduce about our honorable chief guest, Dr. B. Chandrasekhar, sir. He is currently working as technical lead in automotive business division at Tata Consultancy Services Limited in Bangalore. In TCS, he is handling a team of 10 people for design, development, verification, and validation of Tata Group-owned Jaguar Land Rover electric vehicles. Prior to joining TCS, he worked as senior research member at Energy Efficiency and Renewable Energy Division at Central Power Research Institute. Subsequently, he worked as R&D engineer in Solar Division at ABB Group of Industries. He received his PhD degree in Electrical Engineering from CPRI Research Center. He is a professional member in IEEE as well as a member in Society of Automotive Engineers. He is a Board of Studies committee member for New Horizon College of Engineering, SJB Institute of Technology, NBKR Institute of Technology, Nellore, and Global Academy of Technology in Bangalore. His research areas are mainly hybrid electric vehicles, EV chargers, battery management systems, power electronic converters, DC microgrids, and hybrid renewable energy systems. He has been filed 2 patents on the power electronic converters. He has published over 21 papers in peer-reviewed journals and conferences. These are very few things to tell about you, sir. We are very happy for your presence, sir. Thank you for giving this opportunity. Thank you all.
Thank you, Ms. Alekya. Now I'd like to invite Dr. B. Chandrasekhar, sir, to share his inspiring words on this occasion.
Thank you, Alekya. Thank you, Priyanka. Very good morning to everyone. I don't want to take more time because already Srinivas Jasti sir and Vidya Sagar sir and Dr. SVN Lalita ma'am has given the more words about the IEEE. I can request every student, use the IEEE branch for your knowledge improvements like Industry 4.0 or IoT or data science or machine learning or cyber security, whatever upgradation of your knowledge. And meanwhile, don't think about the IEEE membership is a waste of the money. It is a, most of the students will think about the same words. It is for $40 approximately. It is around like 3,000 rupees what I can get from the IEEE. It's just for one day coffee cost. If you assume it like a 365 days into 10, it is equal to that price for IEEE. I don't know much more about the Hyderabad section, IEEE Hyderabad section. I belongs to IEEE Bangalore section. To be honest, there is so many industry people in IEEE Hyderabad section also. It is very good. Even Bangalore section, we got a lot of networking through almost all industry persons are belongs to IEEE Bangalore section. Even Srinivas Jasti sir and Dr. Vidya Sagar sir knows about TCS activities. There is some of the corporate organizations also, they are providing the IEEE membership voluntarily, especially TCS. There is a FC Kohli, TCS founder, he initiated is one of the IEEE senior member. Then coming to the technologies point of view, I'm currently working for automotive sector, that is electric e-mobility sector. There is a lot of plenty of opportunities are available in IT segment as well as in services segment. There is so many R&D centers are venturing to the south, especially now South India has become the automotive hub, especially Chennai, Bangalore, Pune, these three locations. People from electrical, electronics and computer science background, they need to look on the automobility or e-mobility industry. It is a very drastic change. You can't imagine we require more than like 22,000-25,000 people for especially automotive e-mobility segment. There is a plenty, millions of codes are there in electric vehicles. Maybe my lecture, not right now, maybe previously I delivered one lecture about the electric mobility, e-mobility. In future, maybe I will deliver once again that lecture. At last, I need to inform to all the students, I don't want to take more time. Please look on the new interesting areas like IoT, Industry 4.0, automotive cybersecurity, or conventional power system cybersecurity, and be ready with industry standards. Industry are waiting for the students, because recently we took a lot of around 40,000 freshers to TCS. They are directly adapting to our live projects. That is one of the biggest advantage. And meanwhile, who are from electrical and electronics background, there is a plenty of opportunities in renewable energy segment and e-mobility segment. Especially R&D, so many R&D centers are ventured into the south, like a south automotive hub. Great Wall Motors, Mercedes-Benz, there's a Robert Bosch Center, once again, Eaton Center. There is a plenty of organizations are ventured into this segment. Please learn as much as possible from your college and come into the industry with more skills. We need more skilled people for the industry. Apart from the what you have the IEEE or all other activities, even that to venture into the skill, please connect through the LinkedIn to one of the few people from the industry versions. They know what they are doing in the industry. You can connect with them before coming to the industry. Learn from them. Maybe already Justice or Srinivas Justice sir has mentioned, you have to hunger to display your hungriness to show the industry people, because they are already occupied with their back-to-back meetings and their schedules. Please connect with them and learn more knowledge and improve your knowledge through IEEE. Maybe apart from the knowledge, you can improve your networking also. That is one of the best thing for IEEE student branch members. Thanks to BEC management, Bapatla Engineering College management, principal sir, and HOD ma'am, Dr. N. Ramadevi ma'am. Thank you once again. Over to Balakrishna.
Thank you, sir, thank you for your wallet.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Priyanka, continue.
Yeah, thank you, sir, for your valuable speech and giving such an inspiring words. And now it's a great pleasure to introduce Dr. N. Ramadevi, ma'am, HOD of Tripoli Department. She received her bachelor degree in electrical and electronic engineering from JNT Kakinada, and she had received the master of bachelor degree in the power system of the Regional Engineering College, Warangal. And she joined in Bapatla Engineering College in 2000. She has around 24 years of teaching experience, and at presently, she is a professor and head of the Tripoli department and IEEE mentor of student branch Bapatla Engineering College. And she has a specialized areas of protection, power system quality, and wide area monitoring and condition monitoring of the power operators. And now I take the opportunity to invite Dr. N. Ramadevi, ma'am, HOD of Tripoli department and IEEE mentor as well, to share some brief words on subsection and student branch.
Thank you, Priyanka. Honorable chief guest of the today's function, Dr. Srinivas Jasti, sir, chair IEEE Hyderabad session. Dr. Vidya Sagar, sir, chair IEEE Hyderabad session. Student Activity Committee, Dr. Lalita Madam, Chair of IEEE Guntur Session, Dr. Chandrasekhar, Sir, Technical Lead TCS, respected Principal Dr. V. Damodar Naidu, Sir, HODs of various departments, colleagues, and my dear students. A very good morning to one and all. It gives me a great pleasure to welcoming all to for the event of IEEE Student Branch Inauguration Ceremony. First of all, I would like to thank all the executive members of Hyderabad Session and Guntur Subsession for accepting our invitation and making us happy with their presence in the today's inaugural ceremony of our IEEE BEC Student Branch. Actually, our journey started a very long back to start a student branch with the initiation of Dr. DVSS Shiva Sharma sir, Professor NIT Warangal. But at that time, HOD stopped at the middle. So later we discussed so many times for revoking the student branch section.
because of pandemic situation, it gets delayed.
Hello.
Hello.
Madam, your voice is audible, madam.
Okay. Thank you. With over 40 years of history of our college, we have reached so many milestones. We consider starting of IEEE student branch is one of such milestones. In this occasion, I would like to talk a few words about our institute. Bapatla Engineering College is one of the 7 educational institutes funded and run by Bapatla Education Society. The college offers 9 BTech programs, 5 MTech, 6 MSc, and 4 diploma programs. The departments of Civil Engineering, Computer Science, Electrical and Communication, Electrical and Electronics, Mechanical Engineering departments are accredited NBA TRICE, Electronics, Instrumentation, Chemical Engineering are accredited TWICE, and Information Technology is accredited once. College is selected as a network institute for the Technical Education Quality Improvement Program, TechCube Phase 1, of the Ministry of Human Resource Development and World Bank. An amount of 11.81 crores was granted to the college under this program. Under this program, 6 departments were modernized with an amount of 7 crores. The college has excellent infrastructure facilities of building with a total plinth area of 6 lakhs square feet, equipped worth of 20 crores. Every department possesses their individual computer centers with latest systems and softwares, 20 Mbps laser line and 40 Mbps broadband network facilities, spacious library of 2,200 square meters with rich collection of more than 30,000 titles and 75,000 volumes, subscription of about 650 journals. So coming to the conference halls for organizing the various events, the college possesses 5 conference halls, 2 more under the construction. College is having professional society chapters of like IETE, ISTE, IEI, and CSI, etc. College also provides the facility for the girl students for in-campus hostel facility with the capacity of 500 students. 11 buses owned by the college for the transportation of day scholar students with subscribed amount of facility provided to the students. Canteen is also run with the subsidized facility, mineral water plants with the capacity of 500 liters per hour. To make the campus eco-friendly, installed 500 kWp solar plant since 2018 with the cost of 2 crores. Approximately about 5.5 lakhs units are generating annually, and 48% of power required for the college needed is generated using this plant. And one more important thing, the solar plant is synchronized with the 500 kVA generator. So in this Andhra region, any institute doesn't have this type of facility. So we are very proud to say that we have some unique facilities available for the students when compared with the pre-competitors. For example, Bosch
Automation Center. This is the one of its kind in the entire Andhra Pradesh, which provides the in-house industrial standard training to the students in the field of automation. The institute have the Cuco Robo under Robotic Technology Center and Siemens Center for Excellence. So some of our institute milestones from the past 3 years, BEC received the best engineering college in the Andhra Pradesh, awarded from the Top Gallant Media Delhi. BEC received AAA+ ranking in the national level engineering ranking announced by National Engineering Ranking 360 degrees for the academic year 2021. As for the higher education review of top 100 engineering colleges in the India survey, Bapatla Engineering College was listed at 46th rank. UGC team visited BEC during October 2019 and gave us an extension of autonomous status for 5 years, valid up to 2023-24. College received ISO 9001 2015 certificate, valid till 2023. BEC received the Best Driver Award from the Transportation Department in 32nd National Road Safety Month conducted during the January 18 to 17, 2021. BEC signed 29 MOUs with industry to get the research projects, FTPs, and student internships. BEC has received first-time Atal ranking for the first time in the range of 50 to 75 for 2021 for innovation achievements. BEC entered MOU with New Mexico State University, USA, in the academic year 2018-19. So coming to the academic and research activities of the institute, has 260 faculty members. Out of that, 70 are doctorates, 59 are pursuing PhD, and remaining are postgraduates who received their degree from the reputed organizations such as IITs, NITs, and universities. 458 papers published in national and international journals from the past 3 years. 213 papers published in national and international conferences. Till date, 31 patents published by our faculties. Coming to the events organized by the various departments, 61 events are organized for the faculty and 156 events organized for the students' point of view. The total number of events attended by our students outside the world is 271. About 20 lakhs amount is sanctioned and received from various funding agencies for FDP conference and research. So this year, that means the academic year 2021, around 986 students are placed and 1145 offers received. So apart from the academics, the college possesses the various student activity cells and NCC and NSS. So the activity cells is SAC, Society for Evoking Community, Center for Creative Arts, AWAS, Interacting Club for the students for developing their skills.
Coming to the IEEE student branch, we have some short-term goals and long-term goals to forward further. Firstly, we want to increase our member strength. For that, we are planning to conduct membership drives. Secondly, we want to focus on technical seminars, which cover most of the Industrial 4.0 technologies. And also, we will plan to conduct some training programs by collaborating resource persons from industry in the field of electrical vehicle and renewable energy systems. So in this important day, I would like to congratulate all the EXPO members of IEEE BEC student branch and every member for their effort in successfully organizing this inaugural event. And also wish them to conduct many more events under this student branch chapter. Thank you. Thank you for giving this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your graceful words and valuable information for us. And now we are having a technical talk on power electronics converter for renewable system by our guest of Dr. B. Chandrasekhar, sir. I humbly invite Dr. B. Chandrasekhar, sir, to lead a technical talk.
Priyanka, shall I share my screen?
Yeah, please go ahead.